students, how have you been? I assume everything is going great there. The students, as you all are aware that we are discussing tense this week, and already we have discussed in our last session present category of this tense, and today we are going to discuss the past form of this tense. So students, first of all, I would like to revise all four forms of the each tense. Tenses are further divided into three main types: present tense, then past, and then future. And these three main types are further divided into four main categories. Four main types. First one is simple. Second is continuous. Third is perfect, and then last one is perfect continuous. So students, today we are going to discuss the past category of tenses. And first of all, we are going to revise, we are going to discuss all the rules of the simple past form. Simple past form. So this type, this category is referring here or denotes to an action. This category express an action that took place in the past, and that action, that work is over now and do not have any connection with the present. The work that you have done in the past, that all the work that you have done day before yesterday or in the last month, all those actions, all these works would fall in this past form of the tense. And this past also divided into four main types: simple, and then continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. So very first we are going to revise simple, and this simple type just state an action. And what is the rule of this simple past tense? It's first of all, as you remember, subject and object remain same always, and the changes that you will notice, all the changes here in the form of the verb and in helping verbs. So see, subject, verb, second form, and then object. Subject and object will remain same. Just you have to focus here that in the simple past category, I have to use second form of the verb. All three form of the verb you all have learned by heart. So the second form of the verb that you all have learned, you are going to use it here. Second form of the verb in this past category. Subject, verb 2, second form of the verb, and then object. It's very simple, and its name is simple as well as the rule also. So see, this is the affirmative category. This is the yes statement. Subject, verb, second form, or object. And if you would like to make it negative, no statement, then just you have to add up here, did not. And here, no need to differentiate between the plural or the singular. You can simply write did not for all the subjects. So see, subject plus did not, and then verb first form. So here you have to, you just might pay a little bit attention that here I have written second form, and here I have changed it into again first form. Why so? Just because here I have already used did, and did is the second form of do. Do, did, done. So with this did, you will not write again the second form of the verb. So simply with did not or did, we have to write just first form of the verb and then object. So see, it's very simple. So students, let's pay attention here on this sentence. I invited all my friends to tea. So you can notice here easily, I invited all my friends to tea. So I is subject here, invited, second form of the verb, invite, invited, second form of the verb, I invited, and then object, all my friends to tea. So what you have done, what the work you have done here, I invited all my friends to tea party or to tea. So see, you can make all your sentences just by following this rule: subject, verb, second form, and then object. You can make as many sentences as you want just by following this. And if you want to make the negative sentences, you just have to add did not. I did not invite. So see, with did not, you will not write again invited. So here, I did not invite all my friends to tea. So see, it's very simple. Now let's move towards the continuous category. So guys, now we are going to discuss past continuous, the second type of this past category, continuous. And continuous that you already have done in the present also, the time, that action, the action that is going on, or so is in the continuity. So this is the past continuous, and this type of this category, it denotes an action. That action was going on at some point or some time in the past, and that action was going on at a time in the past, and it expresses an action that is continuing over a period of time, especially in the past. So this is the past continuous tense. So here the rule that we have: subject plus was verb, first form of the verb plus ing, and then object. And this is the affirmative yes statement. So guys, if you remember, in the present we have already done this rule, but there was a slight change. So what was that slight change? Let's look here. Subject plus is MR, because that was of the present, so we wrote is MR. So here the changes that we have done here now to make it in the past form, to change it in the past. So here we have to pay a little bit attention. Afterward, you can learn in no time. So see, subject plus was verb, verb first form, ing, object. So if you would pay a little bit attention here, you would notice that other things are same here. Subject is same, verb first form plus ing, and object is same. The changes I have done here to make it in the past, it's was and verb. So instead of is and are, I have written was and verb, and other things are same, just like the present continuous. So to make it in the as the past continuous, I have written here was and verb. So here what will our rule now? Subject plus was verb plus verb first form, ing, and object. See, other things are literally same. So you have to just learn perfectly present tense, and afterward you would be able to just make your past and then future. You can differentiate. So now if you want to write a negative form, negative sentence, then just we have to write in between the verb and then helping verb, just we have to add up here note. Subject was not or were not, and then other things are same. Verb first form, ing, and object. So see, I have written one rule here so that you can do here the comparison. We were getting ready to start our match. So see, we were, as per the subject, I have written here were, I have used were. We were getting, get plus ing, getting. We were getting ready to start our match. This is object. And if you would like to make it negative, we were not getting ready to start our match. So see, you can make your all sentences, and just by writing more and more sentences, you would be easily, you would learn this rule, and you would memorize everything by heart. So now we are going to discuss third category of our tense. So past perfect tense, what is the meaning of past perfect tense? Past perfect tense means it denotes an action completed a certain point of time in the past. So in easiest way, if I define the meaning here, so what is the meaning? The action, the verb that is already completed in the past. Past action or past this category already denotes the completed verb, completed action. So what is the rule of this past perfect tense? Subject plus had plus verb third form, object, and this is the affirmative form. So students, just pay a little bit attention here. This rule we have already revised in our present perfect tense, and there was a slight change in the present perfect tense. What was it? Here we wrote has, have. In the present perfect tense we have used has or have, and to make it the same rule, if you want to change the same rule for the past perfect tense, that just a slight simple change, a minute change you have to do. Here you have to write had. Just by adding had instead of has or have, this is the rule of now past perfect tense. So see, it's very simple. So if you have learned very carefully all the four categories of present, simple one, continuous, and then perfect, and then perfect continuous, then you can here make the differences by your own. Now, to make it past, subject plus had, we have to write verb, third form of the verb, and then object, these are same. And if you want to make it negative, then main verb and between the this helping verb, we have to just add here not. So what will be our sentence? It had rained the whole night. It means our subject. Had, we have to add here had without paying attention to the singular or the plural. We have to simply write had. Here we don't have any choice. So it had, and then rained, and third form of the rain, rained. It had rained, and then the object, the whole night. It had rained the whole night. And if you want to write here negative, then it had not rained the whole night. So students, see, it's very simple to understand. Just first of all, you have to familiarize yourself. You have to just learn first of all the present, all four categories, and afterwards you can make the changes, the slight changes. And look, it's really very easy to do. Students, now we are going to revise the last category of this past tense. And this is, as you all are aware, past perfect continuous category. And first of all, let me tell you what is this. As I have described in the present also, present perfect continuous tense. So this is what it is, the past perfect continuous. It is used to express an action that began before a certain point of time in the past, and that action continued up to some time, and especially this action now has not got any effect left at the time of speaking. So this is the past perfect continuous. So see students, what is the rule? As we have done in the present, you can here make your own comparison. What was the rule? Here it was has, have, we have written, and other things were literally same, ditto, we can say. Subject plus had plus been, verb first form plus ing, object, or since and for. Other things are same. So you can make this memorize, you can learn this very easily. So subject plus had been, verb first form plus ing, and then object since and for. It's really very easy to do if you have learned. In case if you have learned the present tense, and if you would like to make the negative, then just you have to add here not between the helping verb and the main verb. Had not been. So see, I have written one sentence for you. Sumit had been trying to get a job for quite some time. So just match with this. Sumit had been, try plus ing, trying. Sumit had been trying to get a job for quite some time. So guys, here we have completed the past category. And now what you have to do, just write down all the rules in your copy and side by side write 5 to 10 sentences of each category plus affirmative and then negative also, and just try to make more and more sentences and try to pay attention while speaking how many tenses you have used. Until then, take care of yourself. Thank you.